everyone. Welcome to this week's video, this month's memory planner video. It is the middle of November, and I am here to share with you what's happening in Memory Planner by way of Stop the Blur kit and the subscription Stop the Blur video. And so I'm super excited to jump in. So let's do just that. Okay, jumping right in here. You're looking at the first page of October. I snuck this in the September's Memory Planner walkthrough. So you've probably already seen this a little bit. Just to kind of back up a little, I am using the Craft Memory Planner insert, and I just think it's perfect for the fall. And of course, this book will also include December. So this book will hold 3 months. It's going to have October, which is what this one's starting with. I haven't done any of my monthly pages. This is not a new story. It's going to have October, November, December. And so far, so good. October is in here. Now, the thing about this page here that I did want to point out and just sort of wanting to share with you, not only my process, some of my ideas, I get asked a lot about product and what actually I have and am using on my page. But the thing about this page here, I think for me, this is like this quintessential memory planner page sketch. It's very gridded. And I've already listened to... Okay, so let me just segue here for a second. I love to have these posted as soon as the Stop the Blur, the new Stop the Blur kits and the new Stop the Blur videos are available. Well, this girl here is playing catch up with her life because the circumstances of this life have been just beyond control for like weeks now. So I'm saying that because I've already listened to Heidi's introduction to the November Stop the Blur, and I'll have all that linked below. If you're brand new and you have more questions, please ask me questions, but the links will take you to where you can get a lot more details. Anyhow, the thing is, she talked in there about her attempt to try to simplify, and it's just not her vibe. It's just not how she goes about it. She tried and it doesn't work. And I totally get that. Although I am going to have to find one of her beginning Stop the Blur videos. She did share a very straightforward page. I've been thinking about that lately. I'll have to find that. But anyway, okay, I'm a lot of words here. Anyway, this is just a great grid where you've got each of the days have three elements in them. And while it's kind of soft down here, for the most part, it just shows off like a grid. So here's my point. If you are looking for some way to just, you know what, this is taking too long, I'm not loving how long, I love the process, I love having the result of it, but I don't know how long it takes, then just grid it out. Photo, journaling, and you don't have to have another photo, maybe you do, or maybe it's part of the principle. So as we look through these pages, I am in October's pages, and I will be using October Stop the Blur kit. So you're going to see that pretty heavy. Every once in a while, I have thrown in some things from the brand new November kit, which is bomb. Oh my word, that is such an amazing kit. But for these pages, I wanted to use up my October kit. And so I'm just going to go through here piece by piece. And let me know if that's something that works for you, if you just like to know where everything started from and what I was thinking. So this here is a good example of a sort of grid page. It's fairly linear. This, not so much. I got a lot of overlapping and a lot of interactive. And I will tell you, there are so many flips on this month's pages. I was just into the flip, and I'll just start right here. So to clarify too, my photos on this particular page, I size them down in Photoshop Elements to 2 inches wide. That automatically makes them 2.67 inches tall because I almost always take photos with my camera. I'm sorry, with my phone, which I'm actually going to change over to my camera a little bit more here going forward. But when I do take them in my phone, I almost always take them portrait format. So that's what you're seeing here. Sometimes, like over here, these are 2x2 because 2x2 fits perfectly inside each of the days. So I started here with this photo and I use the craft pocket that is part of the October kit. And inside I have a tag for some hidden journaling. And then I flip the whole entire envelope and there's more room here for journaling for sure. I'm going to grab these out of the kit. These tab notepads are phenomenal. And I have it here and I cut up part of the printable and add that here. This is part of the printable. She who seeks beauty will find it. Oh, I love that quote so very much. It's so good because it's the truth. You guys, you look for the beauty, you will find it. And that's kind of what my memory planner is. It is the beauty in each of my day in one way, shape, or form. We get down to the next day and I have another flip here. And for my flips, I should probably process this out sometime. But for my flips, I'm using the sticker paper, which you can find in the Heidi Swap Shop. And I will come in at 1/2 inch and score it. Then I will trim that to be a full inch. That way the 1/2 inch score is in the middle. Then I trim it down to fit my photo. And that's how this flip is made. These little arrow notepads come now in a variety of colors. And I use the black ones pretty much exclusively. That's just how I am. And then here's a photo here. And then this is something you are going to see throughout my pages is that I put out a quote at least once a week on my Instagram feed, something that's speaking to me at the time. This one is every day should be some type of making day. And that was from a Tim Holtz live Instagram live that he did. And he just went off about creating and making and taking the pressure off and enjoying the process and not having an end result. It's just the whole thing I'm preaching right now. So that was a really important thing of what was going on in my making. And so I added that to that day. And then down here, we have underneath, this is from the October printable. Let me get those words out. That would really be helpful. And then I not only journaled on top of this, and it says October stuff here. I think that's adorable. But I have journaling underneath. Now, another thing, if you guys do your memory planners all at one time, like you do all 4 weeks or 5 weeks or whatever it is at one sitting. If you're like me, you're going to find themes that come to the surface. So I've already talked about flippables. The flippables was a big theme this month, but so is journaling. I am super journaling heavy. And I alluded to already that this month, even November, but October was just replete with all kinds of life circumstances that just kept coming to the surface. So I found myself just journaling a whole lot, and I've wanted to move more towards a journal heavy approach to this. And I really succeeded this month. So just a simple photo. The cozy there is from the alphas from the October kit, which I used to a great extent. Now this, the Saturday layout here was inspired by Heidi's Stop the Blur video for October. She did something very similar to this. I didn't quite go to the detail that she did, but it's kind of the same idea with photos. And then each of those photos have journaling. And especially if you have a day that's kind of broken up in a different way, there are like different elements happening to our Saturday. And it was a great way to be able to kind of speak into both of those. Another thing too, Heidi's been talking about is including your makes. Take pictures of your makes. What are you creating? What's going on? I mean, it's part of your life, right? You're making is part of your life. It's part of who you are right now. It's that art that is seen. It's the words that might not be spoken, but they're seen. And so include those some way, shape, or form on your pages. That's my encouragement to you. So again, with that tab, and I use it here again I use it for journaling here. I used it here for a pocket because I like pockets. And so it's just easy to put a 1/8 inch a double-sided adhesive on three sides just makes an automatic pocket. And these photos, I then added my journaling on the back of them. They're just slipped right in here and ready to go. So this was a super fun page. I really enjoyed pulling this together. And you can see there's a lot of white space here. And I'm good with that. And I embrace that. And I enjoyed having that there. I'm super glad that's there, actually. But this starts here with another technique that Heidi shares in her October Stop the Blur class. So you can see it's an accordion book. And so she shares how she put that together using these October kit like foldable envelopes. Not really sure how else to call them. This adventure is a die that is in the shop, and I was going to use the positive, the actual word, but after I cut it out, I love so much how it looked. And this is not done because I got to do a couple things here. I want the journaling to be underneath, and I haven't added my journaling in yet, but this is a little delicate, so I think I actually need to add some vellum to help keep everything together and not so loosey-goosey. So that's one thing I learned as I did that. This is another piece from the October kit, and I love this like circle, like accordion thing. And then because I discovered these butterflies on my dad's sunflower bush, they were all over the place and they just delighted me. So I took a picture of them, and then I had to, of course, have butterflies on my page. And I just thought it looked so fun. And so again, with another Instagram quote from yours truly. And then super simple, I just a lot of pictures of nature right now because fall is my vibe. I just love this time of year so much. Journaling more with the alphas. Added the alphas down here. Then I have this lovely picture with Paige Evans on our way to Milwaukee for She Loves Color, which is what this page is all about over here. Now, I'm going to get so many questions on this, but I'm just going to go ahead and share it with you. So this is a collage that a photo collage that I found in Canva. I've been using Canva, the free version, for a lot of years now for just different, all kinds of different things. I didn't realize there's photo collage on there, and so I popped these photos in from my weekend at She Loves Color, and then downloaded them and printed them on photo paper. And I'm not done with this either because I have all this room now underneath for the journaling and for the details and for notes, and I've got to come back in and still do that. And then I just added a flip of vellum, and this is part of the printable as is the Never Boring, again with the little arrow tag. And then this is from November's Stop the Blur kit. These ghost letters, are you kidding me? Oh my word. Grab these if you don't. Just for these alone, you guys need to have this kit. These are fantastic. She said they're 2 inches long. I guess they are. They look actually taller to me, but let's just verify. Yeah, they're 2 inches tall. They look taller than me. I love them. I was here for them. I could have these in all kinds of wonderful colors, especially all the fall colors. That would be great. I finished up with this notepad that was also from October. Fantastic. I love writing on this. I like having the lines. I'm a line girl. I gotta have lines to write on. I'm always lightly penciling in lines when I journal. I can't freehand to save my life because it's just gonna look like this. It's gonna go like, it's gonna be a complete diagonal. I promise you. So more alpha letters. I used the planner stencil to add that arrow. This is from a printable, and then just a few little notes there. The end of that week. Another fun page. I don't know if I just love these pages so much because of the colorway, because of all the fall photos I took, or because of the kit, because these are my colors, people. These are my colors. I just loved it. I took the inspiration from this page, and I used another one of Heidi's dies, the thankful die, because that's just super appropriate for October anyway, going into November, and then for us here in the United States going into Thanksgiving in November. So I used this time the positive, and I was using a lot of, let me see, I used it here. This is Hallows paper, and I think that's it for now. Oh, this is Hallows paper too that I wrote the ledger paper. There is so many beautiful pieces to the Hallows paper. So that is there with a net. This time this flipped down this way, and then I added one of those journal tags to that, another pocket with some more documenting what I'm making right now. And then again, this time I put the little circle accordion inside of its plastic pouch. And I used a little bit of the brand new November Stamp Society, and I stamped on vellum, and that is what is there. For this craft, envelope. I cut the sides so that this opened completely, and I had fun. This could be a really fun way to do a flippable. Had all kinds of room for journaling, so that was fun. And then just a lot of use of the printables, which I'm always here for. Now, this is a great example of using your makes and including them on your page. So this was a tag. You may have seen that I posted this in Instagram with the reel as well as to how to do the watercolor with This Is the Hollow stamp set on here, plus the October captions. And so that made for me, it just made a nice landing space for another journal spot. And then, of course, a picture of the baby who was 8 months and lots of journaling about that. I loved having these note pads in different colors because I didn't feel like I was just totally repeating myself. And then for this, I took a walk in the garden because it was going to freeze on this night and I knew this was going to be it. So I grabbed a bunch of pictures. I printed them 1 inch by 1 inch and then I just kept them in a strip. And then I told a story about that because that was real life. And then I love having this notes place in the planner because there was a lot going on this Sunday. Oh my goodness. I'm so glad I have this place to put all of this information because there was a lot going on and there's a lot of details and I'm glad I have a place to keep them. That's for sure. This is a very different page for me. It was my daughter's 19th birthday and I sort of just kind of was playing. Literally, it was just playing with some new stamps. This is the October Stamp Society, of course, Heidi's Dies, but I already had this sort of set up. And so I just made it a flippable and I added it inside of my planner. I used the days of the week stamp to give some direction to my journaling. Here's more Hallows paper, more journaling there. This is a label from the November Stop the Blur. And then again, with another tag that it's on my when I make these very often, if I don't give them away, then I will put them on my inspiration board. So I'm starting to pull things off my inspiration board as I've slowly start to transfer into Christmas makes. So slowly but surely, I'm pulling those off. I did this again here, and this again was celebrating a make. This was Tim Holtz Lumberjack plaid, which was not going to go with the colorway I had going on there. So that was a great way to have a story laid out, but kind of hid in that accordion way. And same thing with here. More notes in here. Oh, I just love this so much. Okay, so here's our little sneak into November. And I use vellum here to overlay these photos. This is all November Stop the Blur. Here is Stamp Society. Oh my goodness, it just keeps getting better and better. So I'm probably going to sneak, I'm probably going to sneak some November pages because I really want to get to them as the month goes on. It's a full month. There's lots happening. Gosh, guys, thanks so much for coming in here and hanging out with me for a few minutes and seeing what's taking place on these memory planner pages. You help keep me accountable because there's lots of times I just wanted to not try and get this done, but I kept telling myself, no, Jane, if you stop, you're never going to get back to it. And while you have the mess out, while you have the kit spread out, while you have all your stamps out, just get her all done, guys, if that's the encouragement you need. Well, that's the encouragement I have for you. Thank you so much for being here. If you have any questions, please let me know, and I will see you in the next video.